Hello, friends.
Hello, friends.
Time for a haircut.
Start somewhere. Go. Just cut the stuff up. Gotta be careful not to poke your hand too much. Sometimes that can be a little painful. You just gotta kinda be daring enough to do it if it looks about right. Of course, it's always gonna look a little goofy. So never disable yourself. Never say to yourself, no, I cannot achieve this. Of course, it is all in the mind's eye. You have to be comfortable doing something that may initially seem kind of detrimental. Actual character that you take out of yourself every time you cut your hair is very little. It kind of adds a little character, I'd say. It's too easy to let everybody do everything for you today's society, because of course it's all a luxury to have everyone do everything for you. So instead of cutting your own hair per se, you would pay another individual to do so. And that individual, they want to make the money, they have to cut hair. But it's just scissors and stuff. So you really just kind of have to pick your fights. And sometimes you can get kind of crazy. Sometimes I just think having the luxury of everyone doing everything for you kind of cripples you on some end, some respects. So if you're not able, just go in there and take care of it. Dependent. And why are we so dependent on everyone else to do little things, like take care of our hair? It's little. It goes back. It goes back when it wants to. You know, I know we put a lot of emphasis on outward appearance in today's society, however, I think it's a very shallow thing. It's a small stereotype of success that really bases people's perspectives on things like that. I think those are little things. As you can see, I'm not sure if you can. I've done a good job trimming the upper here. Looks like I got a little bit more room here. Perhaps went a little short there. I got a little bit more bang than I probably need right about now. Trim this up a little bit, not too far in the back. However, as you can see, it's still pretty lengthy. This side is the unaffected side, so comparatively different to the shorn ends. Of course, there's a few loose ones. You always got to be careful. There's a little instances around the ears where sometimes you need to kind of get in there. And don't be illusioned, I don't use scissors the whole entire time. However, I let it judge a general length across my head, and I do so in a fitting manner to where I self-evaluate from the perspectives I can have. Quite literally, half the fun about doing your own haircut is finding out where you messed it up. And then, hardly want to worry about your bangs. Now my bangs are very short, but that's okay. I don't really care. I'll grow them back in its own perspective, right? Make sure I don't remember there. So, it's developing. A little slow. I admit, this is not a process that you would undertake if you're in a rush. You pay for the luxury of time going to get your hair cut. Because that's something much easier for someone else to take care of. So, I can give you a little cutout on this, because I'm looking a little haggard now. It's not looking too good yet, but I'm sure it will. However, I just lost a crazy huge patch right here, even though it's kind of odd lengths. All of this into the back need to be done. So I have quite a ways, and the back is very difficult. But I have, however, managed to do that on several occasions with just sort of general feeling and snipping and things like that. And then trimming up the neck, I just do so by thought. I just take the buzzer and raise it up the back, and I'm just like, okay, whatever. Usually works out. I haven't had a problem. You get better and better at this with time. And sometimes, if you do it like this, you can come to a really cool conclusion. Mullet, that's a patch. That's a weird patch. I don't. This side's better. I like this side better. Even though I don't.
if I got bullet potential.
It's pretty punk, pretty hardcore to do it this way. So I'll need to take a break from time to time. You know, this might just do it. I might just rock this butch mullet. This crazy retarded mullet.
In part two, watch me cut the mullet off.
Make sure you make use of your hair. You can recycle it for bedding. You can put it in a little bag and stuff it into a linen sack. And then you just have a bed of hair. Now what better than a bed of hair to show your appreciation for someone? It's the gift that is never forgotten, because you always sleep on it. It's the gift of your own hair for your best friend in a linen sack, just for them. And if you feel extra special, you can hide a candy bar in the hair so that they find it sometime, but perhaps not at a time while it is still not melty.
Cut your own hair, everybody. It's one of the coolest things you can do. That's a very hard angle to get on my head. I'm not liking this hole. Do not stare at the camera. That's probably good. You're probably good. Anyway, I'll give you the full on. That's a weird angle to get on yourself. See how I'm doing that? Amazing camera angles on self. Now I can't see myself at all, but that's okay. This way I can. Yeah.
If anyone else has their own techniques for cutting one's own hair with a pair of scissors, please feel free to leave a comment down below, video comment or any comment. Just a comment in general would be very nice and appreciated. And remember your friends. Next time you take a haircut, save all your hair for that one special friend. And I know cutting my hair seems like a very crazy thing to do, but I've done it like many times before this. I've been frustrated with my hair lately. Can anyone agree? Some people not to the extreme, but why not? It's a very weird conflict of thought, in my opinion. If I have a problem, resolve it. And to me, this is a resolve that I can handle. I can tolerate, I can stomach, I can do it. Not a big deal. Some people, much harder. I understand that. Doesn't make sense to me. Doesn't. So, I just do it because, yeah, works for me. Not crazy, though. Not. I would say the opposite of crazy. I think craziness is caring too much. Craziness often comes when people care a lot about little insignificant things that truly don't matter and are only based on a really weird way of viewing oneself and how oneself needs to meet a standard of something for other people to be able to look at. Like, that's a reasonable thing to think about people, is that there's something so freakishly crazy in a person that we can't, like, relate to them. Why? It's kind of stupid. Sounds really stupid, given that strange just means different, and yeah, everybody's different. So what? So let them. Like, why have to, like, try to tell everyone to be the same? It's not right, man. It's not right. It's not right, dude. It's not right. And I know I'm right, because the sunlight tells me I'm right. Yeah. I chose a good angle to finish this at. Oh, not a good angle. Better angle. And I'm gonna leave now. And I'm gonna leave you again. But I will be back. Wait for the sequel. Beep, 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 beep.
And I'm gone!